producing a show like this that people never get to see at home.
Yeah, me wheeling a mouse and clicking things, and hopefully things don't break.
People have no idea when you're doing the actual webcast. We saw Brian David Marshall and Rich Hagan back in the booth. Rich's first debut as the full-time announcer for the webcast from the Pro Tour last weekend. And you see that the broadcasters, they have those headphones on. What you don't understand is that there are like six streams of people talking in those things at once. You literally have six conversations going on while you're watching a Magic match and trying to listen to what's happening there and talk about it intelligently. It's actually really difficult.
I mean, I feel bad because I'm one of those streams of people talking to it. I'm like, I hear them talking and I'm like, I don't want to interrupt them, but you just have to. You just start talking. They're listening to other people talk, and they're talking to you, and reading Twitter.
Yep. Yadi Yadi wants to know what happened to Randy Buehler. Randy Buehler, of course, Pro Tour champion, Hall of Famer, former R&D head. He was not fired, killed, MIA, poopy. No, sorry, those are all wrong. He actually stepped down at the end of last year.
Maybe Peter Spaghetti beat him.
That's true. The guy has strong connections in the Italian mafia. Is that actual Randy Buehler?
It's a coin flip, which I always lose. But I'm suspending disbelief. Every, you make a name, it says someone I know, it's got to be the real person.
Except for
that John Finkel guy.
Randy Buehler, alleged Randy Buehler, says, Bill, do you enjoy covering these events more than the Pro Tours? The answer is that actually both events offer different things, and that because I get paid to do both of them, I would never say I prefer one or the other. But the truthful answer is both of them offer different elements that I enjoy. That's kind of how I feel. I like both of them.
I think it's really Randy. It's polite enough.
Yeah.
But that weren't Randy.
He's using punctuation incorrect, spelling actually, and grammar.
We put out what is the best card in all time of Magic. You could gauge alleged Randy Buehler's response and determine whether that was
good. All right, let's see what he types. It takes a couple of minutes.
Sure.
It's a good 2-minute delay.
Delay in the
feed. It depends also on your computer.
Have you ever considered upgrading from AOL as your internet service provider?
Well, I mean, they send you those free discs.
They do.
So it's kind of hard, and I keep saying, you know, I'm done. I want to get rid of AOL, and then they give me a free year. So why would I, you know, go anywhere else?
I think that's actually the real Randy Buehler.
Yeah.
He answered correctly.
Yeah, it definitely is.
I saw this was great. I was in the Wizards office this week, and Randy actually stopped by, and his little daughter was there. She's adorable. She was watching someone was play Magic, and Randy's trying to explain it to her, and she's like, wait, that's the computer, that's the game you play on the computer. Randy was like, yeah, that's the game I play on the computer. And she says, I saw you win that one time. we couldn't help but laugh. But
hey, look, I'm on the stream.
You are.
with two underscores.
Ah,
I think is someone already on here with one underscore?
That's how they get you.
Well, I mean, I am pretty good. I have been known to be on the stream and commentating on myself on the stream before. That's happened.
That's true.
I'll show you the video.
Someday we're going to do a behind-the-scenes look at how we put this stuff together. Some of the crazy stuff that we have to go through to make sure this comes to you guys live. It's just unbelievable. You wouldn't believe it.
A lot of duct tape. Let's just say that. A lot of duct tape.
And a lot of
love. A lot of driving through Richmond.
Duct tape, driving, and love. For you.
So interesting blog stories today, looking to get interesting stuff from people. One of the things about doing 40 of these events in a year, or however many is, it's a lot, is you always worry about recycling the same ideas over and over again. So I'm happy to open it up and see what thoughts people could come up with and see what type of suggestions people have for blog entries, what you guys kind of want to see. We'll probably do another photo essay. I just did an interview with Colossal Fuentes to kind of talk to him a little bit about how he came to Magic and Legacy in general. Really interesting fact about Colossal, he actually started Magic playing Legacy.
Yeah, we were talking to him yesterday, that's what he said, and then he like played a ton of Legacy and then quickly got burnt out on it after a month or two.
That seems wild to me to actually play Legacy as your beginning format, so... All right, we've got future matches here. I'm going to go pick those, and then
you
we'll
can
talk
pick them
to
right
guys
here.
Later.
You can pick them right together. Everyone's leaving me. Gotta do the secret pick the feature matches. They don't want you to know their secret methods. They are ripping up all the names, put them in a hat. So they're all ripped up in a hat. Now they took out a weather vane. It's weird. I don't know what that has to do with feature matches. Threw some ashes on, threw some dust on a fire. It's got like a cauldron going. And then now he's gargling alphabet soup. He spit out the alphabet soup into a sink, and I think he has a name. So now he has one name. Now they, I don't know how to get the next feature match. You cannot have my hat. No more hats for sale. So I hear the feature match is being called. We're going to get the match. I'm not sure which one, but as soon as we get those names, we will get the feature match up and get you rolling back on some magic. Until then, I think Vinecropotence is a good card, too. Probably not the best card in magic. I'm still a Gaia's Cradle fan. It's just so much mana. You can have Necropotence, Randy. I'll have Gaia's Cradle, and then we'll make some decks and see who wins. I challenge Randy to the Necropotence versus Gaia's Cradle match. See who gets the win. All right, so we're going to have James Allen versus Nate Volkt. James Allen, a friend of mine, used to be from the Chicago area. I think he's moved to this area. I think he's out in Virginia now. I think he might be playing 43 Land, which is one of my favorite decks. So you get to see that in action. Not sure what Nate's going to be playing. See if we can get this info up for you guys. See who's on which side. It's like James Allen is on the right side. Alright, so this is round three. I think it still says round two right now. I can fix that in a second. Round three, this is Legacy. You are watching the StarCityGames.com Open Series coming from you live in Richmond, Virginia. It's Rashad Miller. Ben S.W. Swartz is off having a snack, but he'll be back in a second. And right now, we're going to get a round three feature match with James Allen, which I believe is playing 43 land or 38 land or some number of land versus Nate Volkt. I am not sure what he's playing just yet, but we will sneak a peek while he's shuffling.
James Allen, a local ringer from Chicago, actually, who recently moved out to North Carolina.
Oh, is that where he moved? I knew he moved over to this area, so he's out in North Carolina. He used to be in Chicago.
Yeah, he moved to North Carolina for Coast Guard. I don't know too much about Nate Volkt. How do you pronounce his last name?
That's Volkt.
Volkt? Volkt.
I believe he might be playing a five-color ally deck.
Really?
Yeah. I think it's flashing Mistform Ultimus.
Mistform Ultimus. What does that guy do?
He's every creature type.
So he's also an ally?
He is.
Looks like, Nate is a Legacy player. From the area, it looks like.
He is a local Legacy player. Plays a lot of, Legacy. Looks like Legacy exclusive for a lot of his, finishes have been in Legacy?
Sorry, he's a Legacy player from Michigan.
Oh, he's from Michigan?
Local store in Michigan, yeah. He played in Legacy, vented wallet.